Sometimes vendors whom we owe money to offer us terms. Terms in this case really means an early pay discount that's listed on the vendor's bill. We already learned when it comes to an early pay discount that the reason they give it to us is vendors are pushing us to pay them faster for the unpaid bills that we owe them. This idea is very similar to what we learned when we learned about customer discounts and giving customers the early pay discount. Terms means the conditions for receiving an early pay discount. The discount date is the last day that we can pay and receive the discount. For example, if the terms listed on the bill from the vendor are written this way, it reads 2-10 net 30. That means there will be a 2% discount if we pay within 10 days of the date of the sale or at least the date of the service that was provided from the vendor. A second example reads 3-15 net 45. If those are the terms, that means we would get a 3% discount if we paid within 15 days of the sale. For example, let's imagine that the date the service the vendor provided was February 14th. Let's imagine the terms on the bill that the vendor sent us was 4-10 net 30. That means that the discount date would be February 24th because that's 10 days after the date of the service. The due date, which is the final date that we have to pay, will be March 12 because March 12 is 30 days after February 14th. Remember, most years, February only has 28 days. There are three steps to setting up an early pay discount. First, we have to put a discount account in the chart of accounts if we want to track the total money that all vendors have given us for discounts. Number two, we have to put the terms that they are offering us on the terms list so that we can utilize these terms when we enter a bill. And number three, if we have permanent agreement with vendors for the different terms, then we should put the permanent terms in the permanent vendor information in the vendor center. Please note, vendor early pay discounts are slightly different than customer early pay discounts. Number one, sometimes instead of a special discount account, we just reduce the expense or asset from the bill. That means if we have an expense for $1,000 and then we pay with an early pay discount, that expense will decrease by the amount of the discount instead of putting the discount in a special account to track it. Number two, the terms list in QuickBooks is the same for both customers and vendors. So when we get to QuickBooks, you'll notice that the terms list is the same in addition to the term that we already added to the terms list. And the enter bills window is a little bit different than the create invoice window for customers. It allows adjustment of the due date right there on the bill. And that's something that the open invoice or the create invoice window did not do. So let's take a look. When we click vendor, enter bill, we get the enter bill window. Now, by default, the due date will automatically be calculated as 10 days after the date of the bill. That's the way it is if you do not choose special terms. For example, if I make this March 26th and push tab, April 5th is exactly 10 days after March 26th. Even if I make this May 30th, and I push tab, you can see that June 9th is exactly 10 days after May 30th. Let's go back and put today's date, St. Patty's Day, and when I choose terms, you'll notice the due date changes. For example, if I choose terms net 15, the due date becomes 15 days after today's date, the date of the bill. If I put net 60, you can see the due date becomes 60 days after the date of the bill. This is great. Now, if we try one of the terms over here, 210 net 30, what happens? Oh, 210 net 30 means that the discount date is 10 days after the bill date, and QuickBooks calculates that as March 27th. And net 30 means the final due date is 30 days after the date of the bill. If we leave these terms and change the date up here, for example, we make it April 1 and we push tab. Well, if the bill date is April 1 and the terms are 210 net 30, QuickBooks automatically calculates the discount date as 10 days after the date of the bill, and it automatically calculates the due date as 30 days after the date of the bill. When we studied early pay discount for customers, we already put special terms on the terms list. Remember, 315 net 40 was called good customers. So when you look at your terms list and you see good customers, just remember these are the terms. And the great thing is that we are able to use the same terms on the terms list for customers that are already set up if one of the vendors offers us those very same terms. Let's go ahead and put each vendor's terms in the vendor center. Let's make Con Edison 110 net 30. Let's make Verizon 210 net 30. And let's utilize our good customer terms, because UPS is giving us these terms that are already on our list. From the main menu, click Vendor, Vendor Center. And of course, we have all the permanent information here in the Vendor Center that we've seen many times in this course. Let's double-click Con Edison and give them the terms that they agreed to, Payment Settings. Once again, we're in the Edit Vendor tab. Edit Vendor window, the Payment Settings tab, Payment Terms. Here is the terms list, and it's the same terms list that we use for customers as well. Put on 110 net 30 and click OK. Who else? Well, Verizon gives us 210 net 30. So we'll double click Verizon. The Edit Vendor window opens, and we click Payment Settings, Payment Terms, 210 net 30. Then we click OK. And of course, UPS is giving us our good customer terms, 315 net 40, because we are a good customer of UPS. Double click, Payment Settings, Payment Terms, Good Customer, click OK. Our first sample transaction reads, May 14th, receive the electric bill from Con Edison, $1,000, number 8472. Now we will use the Con Ed default terms to enter this. From the main menu, click Vendor, Enter Bill. And of course, we already know how to enter a bill. This is May 14th. As soon as we choose Con Edison, notice not only electric expense comes up, but Con Edison's default terms automatically comes up, and therefore the discount date and bill date are automatically calculated. The reference number is 8472, and the amount is $1,000. When we push tab, it puts it in both places in the bill window, and that's how you would record the bill. Save and close. May 15th, paid in full the electric bill that we just entered for Con Edison. If we pay it the very next day, then we know we're entitled to the discount. You should note, however, we will not have a separate account to track the total vendor discounts. Instead, the discounts will simply decrease the expense that relates to the bill. We know a bill from Con Edison is always electric expense, so that will be the account that we choose for our discount account. From the main menu, click Vendors, Pay Bills. Of course, we choose Con Edison, and of course, we choose May 15th. Now, notice this is the only bill that has a discount date. When we click on it to select it, we can see the terms here. In order to be able to click Set Discount, we have to click the checkbox in the margin, which tells QuickBooks we're paying the entire amount. That's the only way we will get the early pay discount. Once we check the box to tell QuickBooks we're paying, then we click Set Discount. Now, notice, QuickBooks knows the amount of the bill, knows the amount of the discount, and knows the amount to pay. Of course, we do not have a separate account to track the vendor's discounts. Some companies might, but most companies simply reduce the expense that relates to that bill. So we will choose electric expense only because this particular bill was for electric expense. You must make sure you know what expense or what asset was listed on the bill in order to reduce that expense or that asset when you choose it in the discount window. When we click Done, you can see that we are only paying $990 and cash and bank will only decrease by $990. Electric expense will decrease by the $10 and the entire $1,000 will be removed from the balance of Con Edison. Pay selected bill. We're up to check number 218. Click OK and then click Done. How can we check the results? Well, when we look at the trial balance and we double click the cash and bank account, at the very bottom, the last transaction was check number 218 for only $990 because we received a $10 discount. When we find electric expense and we double click electric expense, we can see at the bottom there is a credit. There is a decrease to electric expense for the $10 discount. So electric expense increased by the $1,000 of the bill. But when we found out later we were getting a $10 discount from that electric bill, we decrease our electric expense by $10.